Today, we're going to talk about the many different types of mead in the world of mead. Let's get started. So in the world of mead, there are lots of different styles for one, and then there are different kinds. So we're going to run down and talk about each different one. First of all, I'm going to break them into different kinds of mead. So we're going to start off with your traditional mead. That is a mead that is just honey, water, and yeast. Nothing special. I mean, it is special, but nothing extra added. Then we're going to move to an acerglen. An acerglen is a mead-ish that uses maple syrup as its base. Now, this is a contentious one because some people don't consider them to be meads, but I would throw them into our whole sphere of mead making. Then we have the black mead, which is a black currant-based mead. It is essentially a mellow mel, which is we'll talk about in a moment, but is a fruit mead that uses black currants. Then we have a piment. A piment is a mead that uses grapes slash grape juice. It's very wine-esque. It's a grape juice-based mead. And there are, of course, different varietals you can make within that realm with your different grapes. The next one is the metheglin. A metheglin is a mead that has spices, has botanicals, so flowers, stuff like that. Anything that is considered a spice put into a mead by itself is a metheglin. Now, if you were to make a pear mead and then add a spice in, it's not a metheglin anymore. A metheglin is only the honey, water, yeast, spices, slash botanicals. The next one is a cider. A cider is an apple-based mead. This is a mead that uses apple juice often as its base or apples. And this is kind of a tie between the two. This can be a mellow mel sometimes in people's brains or a cider. Most of the time when you use apple juice, you would consider it a cider. The next one is a rotomel. A rotomel is a mead that uses rose petals or rose hips in it. And it is basically your traditional mead plus rose flavoring in some sort. Now we have a capsaicinmel. A capsaicinmel is a mead that uses peppers of some sort. And capsaicin is the heat that comes from peppers. So if you're putting ghost peppers, jalapenos, serrano peppers, whatever kind, into a mead, you're making a capsaicinmel. Our next one's a bochet. A bochet is a mead that uses caramelized honey, or the process of heating the honey to caramelize certain sugars. This changes the character of the mead, therefore making it a different style. It also makes it a very interesting and quite nice thing, in my opinion. Now we have a mix of the two. This is a bochet o'mel, it's hard to say, but it is a mellow mel, which is a fruit-based mead. Any sort of mead in the world that's just a pear mead itself would be considered a mellow mel, and your bochet. So bochet o'mel is the two things, slammed together: caramelized honey and fruit. A braggot is a mixture between a beer and a mead. So this is a, this can be done in lots of different ways. Some people will make a beer first and then add honey, and other people will make a mead first and add the malt and do all those things. But the big thing here is most people consider it to be a braggot if it is 51% honey as the fermentable sugar. That's kind of the tough thing. Some people go different worlds. Some people say as long as it has honey in it, it's a braggot. It's kind of up to interpretation. A morat is a mellow mel mead specifically using mulberries. Now mulberries are these little bitty tiny things. They are, when you think mulberry, you think of blueberry. It's not really like that. They have their own distinct flavor and taste. A coffee mead, exactly what it sounds like. It is a mead that uses coffee beans, coffee itself, some sort of coffee additive within the mead to make it taste coffee-esque. The next one's called a show mead. It's often also called a traditional mead. And I'm gonna kind of put those side by side because a show mead to some people is a mead that uses honey, water, and yeast, and that's it. When I think of a traditional mead, I think of one that is honey, water, and yeast as well. So you can kind of use either term. Show mead is used often sometimes in judging sheets and stuff like that if you enter a competition. A hippocross, this is the next one. This is a piment that includes your spices or botanicals. So a grape-based mead, plus of course your spice you wanna do, or maybe some or maybe some hibiscus of some sort. So it's kind of like a mix between those two. And an oxymel is a mead that uses vinegar in it. I haven't ever seen one of these. I've never made one, but it exists. Another one is a mulled mead. This is a mead that is basically just warm. And so you can take a mead and warm it up and you can call it mulled. That's a mulled, not the bad mulled, the good mulled mead. Here's one I missed. It is a coffee mel. This is a blend between a hydromel and a coffee mead. It can be any fruit and any coffee combination. The next is a bilbamel. This is basically a blueberry mead that uses blueberry juice or blueberries or possibly even blueberry blossom honey. So these next two are the length of time determined to make a mead. So if you want to make a mead quickly and drink it, this is often called a short mead or a quick mead of some sort. And that's basically just a mead that has taken a shorter amount of time, maybe a month, maybe 2 months, something like that. Then you have the other one, which is a long mead. And a long mead is like what it says, it takes some time to age. So let's say you make your mead and you let it age for 12 months to 2 years. That's a long mead, I would say. Now, any mead aged for a long enough time would be considered a long mead. There's not really a graphic of this is when it becomes a long mead. So the next one is a hydromel. A hydromel is a mead that is 7.5% ABV or lower. This is breaking down into different alcohol by volume categories. If you exceed 7.5% ABV, it no longer really becomes a hydromel. Lots of other countries and places call hydromels or call meads hydromels, regardless of their ABV content. The next one is a standard mead. It has a couple different iterations. Some people refer to it as a 7.5% ABV to 14% ABV mead, sitting within that range. You might also see on the market, some commercial meaderies might call something a standard mead and it be a traditional mead, regardless of their ABV content. Essentially, in my brain and lots of other people's, a standard mead is one that is 7.5 to 14% ABV. A sack mead is a mead that is 14% ABV or above. These are often huge, big-bodied meads that have a lot of flavor and need a lot of time to age. So if you make something higher ABV, you might have made a sack mead and you might have to wait a while before you can drink it. Now there are some different things you can do post finishing a mead. You can carbonate it. This becomes a sparkling mead. Anything that is carbonated in the mead world is called sparkling, like you would here anywhere else. If you are putting oak on it, it becomes an oaked mead. So it has the tannic value from oak and the flavors that come with that. That is an oaked mead. So these are most of the meads you'll see around. Are there more kinds of mead in our world? Absolutely. There are regional ones, so you might have a specific kind that is often created in your country, your region. And I could go down a huge list. There's a giant world out there of meads. These are just the general styles. I hope this has helped you. Go out and make some of these kinds of meads. Make sure you're kind of adding some variety to your world and make multiple things so that you can understand more about the world of mead. Thank you for watching. I'll see you next time. Cheers.